Hi folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Ravenloft Strahd's Possession. We are just going to jump right back in here, as per usual, and hopefully do some things. Alright, where we left off, we had gotten the Paladin's eye patch and were told where to find his, the key that'll get us into the, bats, apparently. The key that will get us into... the Undercrofts under Barovia. However, we are not going to do that immediately. I want to do some other things because, as per usual, Sraju has come to my aid and told me what I'm supposed to be doing. In regards to this werewolf here, we already have the spells necessary to cure him. I had completely forgotten that we'd picked up scrolls in the freaking bats, the church catacombs when we were in there, and Sraju reminded me that I had grabbed them. So let's dig those up. There should be three of them. It's Atonement, Remove Curse, and Cure Disease. Let's see, there's Cure Disease. Alright, there's Remove Curse. Let's see, where would be my raised dead bag? Do we have... Wow, we've got three empty bags there. That's good to know. Where is Atonement? Cure Serious Wounds, Flame Strike, Cure Serious Wounds, Cure Serious Wounds, Cure Serious... Ah, there it is. Alright. So these should, in theory, be all of the spells that we need. We've got Gold Leaf here double fisting them. Alright, and we're gonna save before I do this, just in case I screw it up, which is always a possibility. Okay, so let's do this. Cast it on him. Can I not do it on him? I did that. Now the incantation fails. What? Get away. Oh, I accidentally just talked to him. Yeah, I think I might have borked this already. Alright, what do we got here? Atonement. We might have to cast them in a certain order. I don't know. So I'm gonna reload. Alright, let's see what we got here. We have Cure Disease, Remove Curse. I'm gonna open up with the Atonement spell. Like so. Then do that. And then we'll try. Unless it's a special, that Scroll of Cure Disease that we have might be a special one. This one might be a special one. I don't know. We'll try them both. I'm gonna cast it on him. If I just... Yeah, I don't know. It's not letting me cast Cure Disease. Yeah. Come on. Try this again. We'll try talking to him and see if he has anything to say to us. Alright, is there anything we can do? Yeah, listen to you. Three spells must then be cast. Alright. I don't know. Yeah, like, it doesn't let me cast it on him. I can only, like, I can click on my guys and it doesn't do anything, and if I right-click it, the incantation fails. So, I don't know. That's... kind of irritating, because I want to know, like, what we get for helping this dude, but the game doesn't want to seem to play nice, and I don't want to sit here futzing with it for 20 minutes, so back to Gold Leaf's inventory these go, and we will come back here at a later time, I am sure. I'll check the clue book or something, see if there's a specific order I'm supposed to cast stuff in. But for now, Sraju also told me that we are to go where most adventurers go after an adventure, which is to say the tavern, so that's where we're headed. I will be doing side quests probably in... I'll probably set an episode aside for it. Maybe next episode, where I'll just finish out the paladin side quest and do this werewolf thing. But first... I want to go grab that footman's pick, too. I know where the shack is. I think it's right behind the paladin's house. So I've just gotta find his house. Well, there's the tavern. Which, if I recall correctly, his house was over here. Further this way. Okay, is it this one? Yes, alright. So there's the paladin's house. So I'm actually gonna note that. Because, yeah, that's his shack right there. Paladin. Okay. That will make finding him easier in the future should I need to. Got a pretty sizable house for a fallen paladin. And this is his shack where the footman's pick should be, which I hope I did not move, and I apparently did. Crap. That's not good at all. I have no idea where that pick is in that case. Oh, is that it right? No, that's a hammer. Well, in that case, we probably won't be doing his quest because that thing could be anywhere. And, I mean, I know I've got a couple, like, general gear dumps around the world, but I don't want to have to be running around and... Okay, tavern time. Okay. Let's see here. Maybe we should talk to... Well, I don't see any new people floating around. So we'll talk to the tavern keep. See what he has to say. Oh! Glad to see you again, Bray. This tavern has character, welcoming and warm in a cold town. Even that feather of yours seems to welcome us to your nest, eh?
Aye. You're as welcome as your coin. And I hope you've come with more than a were-raven's feather to pay your way. Even that beast, I'm told, pays honorably for services rendered. Of honest commerce, they say, Eluce tilca regebrion.
I believe I've heard it said differently. Isn't that like saying more like, Tiganes ilke eluce akin? What? Alright. Now that we understand each other, can you help us?
I know of the Brother Raven shed free from Strahd's tower. So you are the one? Now why doesn't that surprise me? Still, there was one thing I might do. There is an abandoned warehouse, once known as the Merchant's Pride. Go there and wait for another contact. They will know who you are and they will escort you to yet another party. Someone more able to offer our thanks. It is all I can do.
Alright. I believe I might even know that. I remember poking my head in there. Probably last episode, even. That might be that warehouse that's on the far east side of town here. Okay, there's the shack. Minimap. I think that might be it down there. Cursed load draw distances. No, this is apparently not it. No sign. Okay. Well, we'll poke around a little bit then. Maybe one of these three buildings here. No sign. Also no sign. Excuse me. Ah, here we are. The Merchant's Pride. Yeah, you can barely read the text there. Okay. Minimap. Yeah, there is in fact someone in here. Oh, there's a handful of people in here. I'm gonna go ahead and save. Just in case things get violent. And I haven't have I rested? No, I have not. So I'm not too well armed here. Oh.
Bray Martakova sent us. Do you understand? He told us nothing about a band of brigands, only that you might help us meet the leader of your order.
Brigands, are we? Take care with your words, friend. Should they fall too freely, your head might join them. Then to be sure, the silence above your shoulders would be an empty one. Enough talk. If you want what Bray promised, you'll drink our little drink. A potion meant to close your eyes for a time. 'Tis more certain than a blindfold. And some say it brings sweet dreams.
The one we freed from the tower, how does he fare?
He fares well, and grows stronger with each day that Strahd's dominion nears its end.
You leave us little choice, do you? Agreed, then. We'll drink the anodyne, the potion you offer.
Good. We know of the were-raven you freed from Strahd's tower. All we ask is that you cooperate with us. And for that honorable act, we will guarantee your safety when you are among us.
Okay. Let's see where we are here. Greater Catacombs beneath Barovia. Okay. Ah, Ravenlord. We have braved the sleep of your potion and trusted your men to bring us safely here. Can you help us?
I am Piar 200 Summers, head of the Keepers of the Black Feather, of the fabled race of Ravenkin. Do not you mistake my age, nor the weakness in my eyes for feeble-mindedness. Know that you are alive and in my presence only because of our brother Raven, he whom you rescued from Strahd's tower. In payment for that brave act, I grant you a few moments, no more.
Okay,
Great one. Our quest in this land seems tied to the one man who claims it as his own. What can you tell me of Strahd?
Strahd is the evil that stalks Barovia with malignant certainty. Once he ruled as Count Strahd of the von Zarovich line, a noble warrior who came to free us from the tyrant Dorian. But that was so long ago. I have grown old in my own vocation, in my relentless fever to destroy him and free the land. For now it is Strahd who imprisons us, who has become a vampire lord.
If, as it seems to me, Strahd is the key to our success and our eventual escape, how might we trick him or gain authority over him?
You are ambitious beyond all telling. Only one instrument, one icon of faith and of true fidelity to the ways of light may hold Strahd at bay. It is the holy symbol of Ravenkind. This fearsome object, crafted by the most high priest of the realm in the days when Strahd was immortal, now lies hidden from the light. Its whereabouts are unknown. In all my life, it has eluded me.
Alright.
What can you tell me of this symbol of Ravenkind?
We know of its use by a cleric, a young priest of such ambition that he dared confront Strahd. Indeed, the power of the symbol did grievous injury to our lord, banishing him from the land for many a season. Sasha was the name of the priest. He is supposed to have prepared 3 manuscripts, parchments detailing the whereabouts of the symbol in magically encrypted text.
Why has the symbol of Ravenkind been so difficult to locate, and how might we attempt to find it?
Some may have found it. I do not know. I know only that none have returned alive with it in their grasp. Because you have braved many dangers, including this conference, I have no objection if you wish to try your own strong hands in the matter. If so, I will provide you with a key and a special reading device so that you may make your own attempt.
What do we have to do? How may we begin?
There is a church which has been cursed by Strahd himself. There, if you are able, you will find this key unlocks a door beneath the structure of the place. We believe the 3 manuscripts revealing the location of the holy symbol of Ravenkind are there. Once found, then with a scroll in one hand and the scrying glass in the other, you may read the hidden secrets of the text.
It sounds too easy, Great One. Haven't others done this before?
Of course others have walked the path I set before you. Many were brave, some whose magic was so powerful they could read Sasha's manuscripts without a scrying glass. Sasha did not leave a map with an X upon it, oh no. He left but clues. Clues that when clearly read, but half who see them gain the slightest understanding. I shall watch your progress with great interest.
Pure, this place is too dangerous. We must go.
Yes, I sense them. They are coming. Here is your challenge, then. Prove your mettle. What I have told you can be entrusted only to those strong enough to battle their way beyond the creatures outside the door. Fight! But do not overlook what by chance might fall your way, or be revealed in the corners of this forbidding place. Heed my words, and good luck to you.
Okay. Well, we have another key and the ruby catacomb key. Huh. Alright. So, can I sleep? Yes, sweet. That's the first time we've actually slept for quite a while. But now we have all of our spells. I want to hear. We are not the only one throwing spells, apparently. I want a box. Yay. Room paralysis, cure critical wounds, and some chaotic times alignment along with a negative plane protection scroll that I'm going to go ahead and chow on here. We'll give that to Swell. Alright. Cure critical wounds, I guess I'll hold on to. Where's my Kiog Tom's bag? Oh, the Kiog Tom's bag is full. Okay. Alright, cure disease, neutralize poison. Alright, so I can go in there. That's fine. That's fine. This is remove paralysis. There. Alright. So we just got all kinds of... Look at all this inventory storage. Oh, I love it. Alright, and here's the reading glass, which I'm glad I noticed. Otherwise, I'd be making an ass of myself at some point in the future. Alright, we're gonna save again since inventory management. Let's see what horrors await us. Oh, that looks like a trap down there. Yep! Nice try, game. I've learned your tricks, mostly. Button. Wait for it. Wait for it. Maybe I just turned it off. That's what I'm gonna go ahead and hope. No, I did not. I just got lucky, though. Okay. Well, these are certainly catacombs, that is for sure. Whoa! Whoa! Revenants! Did I kill it? Yeah. Oh, and they level drain. I don't think it got Swell. I don't believe so. I think he was only 8th level. I don't know. Levels lost on Swell don't particularly bother me too much because he's just kind of a frontline fighter. Oh, I got another one on me? No? Music changed. I'm like, what's going on? See, is there a button? No. Okay. Revenants, though, that's an interesting one. Personally, probably not something I would use as random enemy to attack the party, number 72, but hey, whatever. Oh, I see you. Have a nice storm. And come around that corner, and a lightning bolt! Oh, no, no, immune! Damn it. These guys got some hit points. If my party could hit them. Swell okay? Yeah. But yeah, I wouldn't probably use Revenants because of, like, the... I don't know. Their, like, whole thing is that they're vengeance. They're supposed to be, like, avenging their deaths. So why would there just be a horde of Revenants sitting under Barovia here wanting to kill my party? I don't know. Whatever. Oh. Sapphire Catacomb Key. I'm gonna have to start dropping some of these things. I've got friggin' 2 key rings full of keys. Alright, let's get out of here. Let me make weird sounds. Sounds like, I don't know, a dishwasher or something. Alright. Oh, and hellhounds. Oof, been a while since we've seen you guys, and I'm... Yeah, that's not gonna do anything. That might, though. Maybe it would've hit. I killed one. Oh, and I killed two. Alright, how's everybody's levels looking? Not bad. Velika is almost up to 4th level spells. That counts for something, and... Did Goldleaf just level? Yes, she did. Alright, I thought I saw a level thing there. Oh, now we can actually prepare Ray's dead! Oh... Truly, we are blessed! Alright, well, we got some extra lower level stuff too, so we'll take an extra Cure Light Wounds, an extra Draw Strength, which she'll actually, I'm actually gonna grab Draw Dexterity too, because that'll improve her, armor class. Alright, and we're gonna sleep again here. Yes, and now that she's in the front row, these are buffs that I should actually have her casting pretty regularly on herself. I believe they both bump her Strength and Dexterity up to 18. So her armor class, I think, is probably going to go down to -3, I think? Assuming it actually bumps her up to an 18. Only a 17, alas. Yeah, -3. How do I remember that? Ow, fireball. How do I remember that? I played a lot of D&D when I was younger. A lot of D&D. So, yeah. Come on, Fireball. I'm waiting for you. I'm not falling for this trick again. Nope. There we go. Okay. Well, now that I've got her buffed, she should actually prove pretty lethal in the front row. And Draw Dexterity will give her some survivability. However, there's apparently nothing up here, because game be trolling. I'm gonna check the walls, though, see if there's any buttons. Because there might be to open that one locked door. And if not, that's okay, because do not forget that there was actually a another door when we came in. Oh, and see? See, I walked right past a corridor here, and there's a room and things and... And, oh, what is that? Where there's one coin, there must be more. Perhaps enough to purchase that potion of which the gypsy spoke. Well, we have one. Into the chest it goes. Oh, and here's how you open this door. Okay. Let's see, I think it was 15 coins. So good luck getting all those. Uh-huh. I was waiting on that. Okay, let's crack the door. Oh, hey. Horde of revenants. Wow, took them both down. Nice. Ugh. Freaking spinners. Keep those burning hand spells at the ready because, yeah, they kind of tend to jump out at you. Freaking. Alright, and we have nothing here. So back out into the halls. And stuff. Also, I was going to mention it, but it completely slipped my mind because I got distracted by keys and things. That raven and the people that were with him, those are Knights of the Raven, and the holy symbol of Ravenkind is actually something from the Ravenloft modules. It wasn't just the holy symbol of Ravenkind you needed, though, if I recall correctly. There was a couple other things that you could grab to make the fight against Strahd easier. What? Oh, that's a wraith. Yeah. Let's see, did that take out her negative energy protection? Yes, it did. Does Strahd still going? Yes. I know there was the holy symbol, there was the sun sword, which you could get. I thought I saw two of those things in here. And I think there was a third thing too, but I do not recall what it is off the top of my head. I could scoot my chair back and pull the third edition module off the shelf and look in there, but I don't want to interrupt the stream here, because as we all know, this is a professional gig and I never do that. But yeah, I'm actually pretty impressed, in all honesty, with how true to the Castle Ravenloft module this game actually has been. It's pretty impressive. I mean, there's obviously, they're doing their own thing with some of it, but like the major points are there, I guess. And that's pretty impressive. One of these days I'm gonna play through, God, what's it called? I think it's just the Temple of Elemental Evil. It was released, put out by Obsidian, and, or not Obsidian, shit, what's their name? Same people that developed, Vampire the Masquerade, the one that I Let's Played, Bloodlines, maybe? The one that I Let's Played years and years ago. Oh, crap! All in my grill and everything. But yeah, they put that out. They put out Temple of Elemental Evil in the game. Oh my god, is it a horrible buggy mess. But fan patches have gotten it to the point where it's really playable, and it's actually a really solid 3.5 edition D&D game. Like, really close to the rules accurate and stuff. And I do want to play that for you guys one of these days, but it is much the same as, like, Baldur's Gate, in that it is incredibly text-heavy. And I have enough trouble reading Shadowrun, so I don't know. And after Shadowrun, I'm going to be doing Echelon Book 2, which is also, or Book 3, rather, which is also incredibly text-heavy, so I might slot that in after I finish Echelon, which probably won't be until next year at some point. But yeah, that is something that I would like to kind of play through for you guys. I think it'd be fun, and I don't even know what that was. And from what I understand, it's a really solid game. I've not played the entirety of it. I've really only played just the beginning, because when I played it, it was a buggy mess and not fun at all. Oh, come on. Come on, you guys. You need to kill these wraiths before they kill you and eat all your levels. Doubly so with that friggin' hellhound. Come on, gold leaf. Woo! You good? You're good. Alright, let's have her re-up her negative plane protection. And there. We are pretty well out of our offensive cells. Well, we've got Velika here. She's got her full complement of higher level, not quite AoE stuff. Oh, another chest. With a ring of fire resistance. Yay! There you go, gold leaf. I have a feeling that they're giving us these chests so that we can store the gold in them. Because if it is 15, like, soul, like, single pieces of gold, that's gonna be basically two chests full of gold. Oh. Thankfully, gold doesn't have that much mass in pen and paper D&D. Yoink! It's, you know, in pen and paper, I think it's like, it's 50 coins to the pound, and nobody tracks that. Holy crap, we need to not be in this room. Ah. Well, I shouldn't say nobody tracks gold weight, but I have not seen it tracked in a long time. There have been a couple... Oh, look at this. Oh, damn it. There have been a couple campaigns that I've played where we actually tracked, like, coin weight and stuff, but it was mostly due to it being extenuating circumstances, like, when we played the world's largest dungeon. Oh my god, I could tell you horror stories about that module. But when we played the world's largest dungeon, we tracked gold weight in that. We tracked everything in that because, the way the module is designed, it's supposed to be kind of like D&D hardcore mode. And so, like, we had to worry about food and starving and gold leaf, don't you die on me. Drink a potion. Yeah, I'm gonna start using the potions now just because I need to get them out of my inventory. Alright, I need to buff her. We'll finish exploring this little... Damn it. We'll finish exploring this little area here, and then I'm going to call it an episode. But yeah, World's Largest Dungeon, it is certainly a thing. It is certainly a thing. It's an interesting module if you like hack and slash, which is... I enjoy... Like, in... back in... I do not want to be standing... Yeah, that is why I was going to say. I do not want to be standing where I am right now because that fireball trap. But, as I was saying, I do kind of like hack and slash. I favor it. I like role-playing and stuff, too. But in 3rd edition D&D especially, I like the combat system because it plays, like... it's tactical, turn-based combat. And, like, when I was younger, I always loved, like, say, Final Fantasy Tactics, and with 3rd edition, you've got Final Fantasy Tactics with, like, 100 different rule books, and, it makes me happy. But the World's Largest Dungeon is really good for that. However, when it comes to, like, the RP and stuff, you kind of have to make your own there, because there's really not a lot, and the module developers kind of go out of their way to make, like, most everything you fight just wants to murder you. Thankfully, when I was run through it, I actually played in that game. I had a really good DM, and he kind of inserted, I just got chewed on by something. He inserted some role-playing opportunities where they wouldn't have been normally, and that was greatly, greatly appreciated. But yeah, it's certainly a module. It is a mega dungeon, and one of these days, you guys, I'm gonna just do a long video of all of my D&D crap for the fans out there and show you guys some of the really weird stuff you can get. Like the maps for the World's Largest Dungeon, they're poster-sized, and there's about 20 of them. So the map for the World's Largest Dungeon will quite literally cover a wall, and it's pretty impressive. Okay, I need to start. There we go. I think we are going to go a little over. I think I'm going to go for a, 40-minute episode today because I skipped out last Friday's because I wanted to get the episode number progression back on track where it should be. So I will give you guys an extra long episode today. But yeah, World's Largest Dungeon is really good. If you like a more combat-oriented game, and it is very, very old school in the traps and stuff, and that, like, you can be... there's a fireball trap along there, too. Whew. It's very old school in that, like, you can be first level at a trap you can bump into and, like, not notice it. It's like a 400-foot deep pit, and, it's just... gloriously terrible. If you dig that kind of stuff, it's pretty cool. Good luck finding a copy of it, though. I got it when it had first come out, and not only was it expensive, but it was hard to track down a copy that wasn't, like, used in really crappy condition. I need to sleep. But yeah, it's a good mega dungeon for those that like mega dungeons. I'm actually looking into Rapana Thuck is its name. It was put out by Frog God Games, who they kind of pride themselves on. Oh, fat loots! What do we got? Vampiric Touch. Does she already have it? Yes. Velika, you do not, though. Wizard Eye. Gloriana, you have that one. Velika, now you do too. And a cloak. That is non-magical. Crap, what's that? A Wand of Frost. We'll give that to Glorion. I think that's Ice Storm. I think. But yeah, I wanna pick up Rapana Thuck, which I actually did. I ran a game based on some printouts I had on it years ago, and it is, like, it's interesting. The World's Largest Dungeon throws you in a situation in which you have no escape. Once you're in the dungeon, you're in the dungeon and you cannot get out. Rapana Thuck, you've got a town and a pretty substantially sized overworld that you can explore if you want to. However, Rapanathuk traps you with brutality. That dungeon has got some of the most just insidious encounters that I have ever seen, and I am looking to grab a, that's the right one, yep. I'm looking to pick up a Pathfinder RPG re-release that Frog God Games did of it, but it is also incredibly expensive, and I have more important things to spend my money on, like food. So, yeah, but that's an eventuality, and oh, the PC suffering. Alright. I want to check this room again to make sure there's not like a coin in here or something. Okay, is that everything? Yeah. Just making sure. Come on, Velika, you need a level. She's right there. She's freaking 1500 experience points away. That's like probably like a wraith or two wraiths. I got a fireball coming down here, and I do not want to eat that with my face. Oh, we got another coin over here? No, we have a potion of fire resistance. Sure, swell. Oh, and we have something else. Oh, potion of healing to replace some of the ones we've been drinking. Cool. Okay, well, we have an area over here and the door down there that we now have a key to. Am I gonna eat a fireball? No! Am I gonna eat one here? Yes, I was waiting for that, because it is just my luck that I time it in such a way that I get to chew on fiery death. Alright, let's see what we've got up here. Make sure there's nothing too terrible. Okay. Alright. Ah. I see you down there. Is someone over here? No. Alright. Get some up, squeak up to you, and lightning bolt. Because it beats fighting you. It does impress me how expansive the dungeons are in this game. That is definitely impressive. There we go. The only downside to the massive dungeons is that they are so easy to get lost in. I am so glad that the developers were like, let's give them an auto map. See, and I don't believe we have this key. No. That looks like, I don't know, can she pick it? No. Of course not. I'm honestly surprised that she picked any of the locks in this game. Oh, there's a couple. Oh, there's a bunch of stuff in this. Oh. See, this, there's all this loot just sitting in here. This is like, hey, Gene, guess what? This is a death trap. So I'm gonna not go just running in like a jackass. Yeah, I was gonna say, I see a hellhound. Oh, I see a couple hellhounds. The other one gonna come at me? Oh, frickin' walls. Oh, they're coming up behind. Kill him. Oof. Those things, I just cannot get over how hard they hit. I know why they hit hard. It's because their bite attack does, I think their bite's only like, it's like a D4 or a D6, but then they do a D6 fire damage on top of it. And I do not want to be standing right in front of the fireball dispenser there. Wait for this one to fire off before I move ahead. Come on. Actually, I was gonna say, yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything in here. Alright, so let's kinda take cover here where there are no fireball dispensers behind us. What do we got? A potion of extra healing. Another potion of extra healing. Is that a potion of strength or speed? Yes. Okay, so we got two of those and one of giant strength. Here you go. Gold leaf's getting encumbered. Oh, that's not fun. We also have gold pieces. Come on. Grab it. Grab it. There we go. So I think that puts us at six. Yes, six. We're about halfway there. A little less than halfway there. What we got over here? Oh, ring. Alright. I do not want to be standing in the way of the fireballs when I'm looting here. Alright. So that one's gone. What do we got? Come on, take the freaking ring. Ring of protection. Alright. Is it better than the one she has? No. Not better than the one Swell has either. Here you go, I guess, Velika. Because that's useful. Alright. Okay. Oh, and I just looked at my clock and realized we're at 40 minutes. So I guess I'm going to save it and call an episode here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will catch you all next time. We're in more of this, I guess. Until then.